2 months left before baby comes, and I am not slowing down. So to kick off the month, we went, okay, 4th of July. What do I say about that?
Look at the doggies, Cece.
I don't know about you guys, but I actually really hate firecrackers. I don't know why everyone loves it so much. So we're here with our SoCal family having a little picnic barbecue to watch fireworks. Last year, I had a really bad experience. We were dumb and we took Ollie to the park with us just because a lot of other families took their dogs and they seemed to be fine, but my dog is somewhat skittish, so I ended up watching the fireworks. I didn't even watch the fireworks. I ended up on the sidewalk just bear hugging him because he was so scared, and we did not do that again this year. I felt so bad how scared he was that we just kept him at home, and luckily we live in an area where you don't hear a lot of fireworks and noises, so he was happy just being at home.
Ollie, are you ready for a trip?
We got bagels, folks. We got everything cheese bagel, and then we got everything cheese and bacon bagel. Now we're ready to roll back to the Bay Area. We were stuck in the car for 6 hours. This is the first time that I've gotten up a pregnant lady sitting in the car for 6 hours. And this was the last trip that we're taking before the baby comes, and probably for quite a while, since I'm gonna have such a time managing two babies, my toddler and the new baby. So I don't know when our next travel plans are gonna be, but it was so, so nice to go back home. I still consider the Bay Area or San Jose my home, just because that's where I grew up and that's where my family's at, all the history there. But LA is starting to feel like home too. I enjoy it down here. So we are at my mom's new place, and this patio is so cute. There's this barbecue. I don't think it's ever been used before, but we're gonna be grilling some Korean barbecue tonight. I'm so excited. I've only had the bagel this morning, and so mama's ready to eat. Here we have some spicy pork, and then we just have some lettuce, perilla leaves, cucumbers, bulgogi, short ribs, samjang sauce, and then we have a little bit of kimchi, and then more lettuce for wraps. Gotta do it for the gram. I mean, I gotta post this spread on the gram, not eat this for the gram. It was so nice to see my mom's new place. She's finally moved out of my sister's after my dad passed away, and now she's on her own, and I think she's loving it. Independence is good.
Yeah, eating out of the actual bowl.
Did you take the first bite of anybody? Cece, that's not self-serve like that.
I'm sure I'll see my sister's family and my mom and everyone again once baby is born, because I'm gonna make them come down to LA to visit me for the holidays for once. We're always having to drive back, and it's such a hassle, but I can use the baby as an excuse to get people to come here. Heck, I'll even cook for them if they just come down here, and we'll make it an epic spread to celebrate the holidays, Thanksgiving, or Christmas with everything. I feel like it'll be so fun. So the terrible twos have been pretty. It hasn't been terrible, but it has been challenging. So she's starting to throw a lot of tantrums, like lying on the ground. Did you see my face? I was just so over it. I just got my nails done.
Wait.
That night, I couldn't sleep at all because my sister has this sofa bed that's like slightly inclined. And so I kept slipping. And for a pregnant woman to like sleep, I got the worst Charlie horse ever, trying to kind of hold myself in a still position from not sliding down. We had a little bit of a regression after the Phoenix trip because we made the mistake of giving her the pacifier to help with her ear popping. And since then, she would not give the pacifier back. And Nate and I decided that we are probably just gonna let her have it until the new baby comes, because she's probably gonna regress again, seeing how if the baby has a pacifier, she's probably gonna take it from him or her. So we're just gonna let it be for now and then work on taking it away again. I was so happy that we got rid of it the first time, but I have confidence that it'll work again, hopefully. If you guys have any tips for me on how to get that out of the way again, definitely let me know. Good morning. We are in Berkeley, California. This is actually where Nate went to college, but today I am working on a project of my lifetime. It's probably like the biggest thing I've ever done, and unfortunately, I can't tell you guys much about it. But you'll find out soon enough. Soon enough. This is our first time in an Airbnb, and I am super impressed by this Airbnb. It's like brand new, so stylish and clean. That was one of my biggest worries when we were picking out an Airbnb, is that some of them look pretty grody and old, but I was pleasantly surprised with this one. So let me give you a quick tour. So this is the living room. Stylish. It's even better than my place. There's Cece, and then we have her box of toys here. And then here is the entrance. This is the kitchen. This is such a cute kitchen. I can totally see myself filming here, and I love all the natural daylight. It's nice soft light. Obviously, we've already settled in. Boo is just chilling on the floor. Nice farmer sink. We just have eggs. I got some Oatly. Hi, Papa and Cece. Hi. And then our room, which is a disaster already. There's no towel hanger, so I have to use Aracy's pack and play, but this is where she's sleeping. Another shower, and I love these tiles. That is our Airbnb in Berkeley, but now I have to get to work, and I'll show you a little snippet here and there, just so you kind of get an idea of what I'm working on, but I wish I could tell you! I know, I hate it when people say, I'm working on this secret project that I can't wait to tell you about, but contractually, I am not allowed to talk about it, and so I can't tell you. But just know that I will be able to make an announcement, I think, in spring, and I cannot wait to tell you what it is, show you what I've been working on. I'm not just a hand model, even though that was really fun. The wait will be definitely worth it. Any guesses? Leave it in the comment section below.
Fun fact, I'm terrible at chopsticks.
Go to sleep. Go to sleep.
No, okay.
Good morning. Good morning. How was your long nap? All right. Are you hungry? Let's make a green juice.
So after the trip, it was just purely work mode just to get a few projects out of the way. And then I had my 32 weeks appointment where we found out the baby is still breached, meaning that it has not flipped over yet. The baby's butt is still in my pelvis, and that is not the right position for it to be in because it needs to be head down first for it to come out. It's still fairly early, but the doctor was a little bit concerned and she said, since my next appointment is not until 35 weeks, we need to start working on flipping the baby because otherwise at 36 or 37 weeks, we have to schedule a C-section.
I'm trying to get the baby out of my pelvis and trying to get it to...
I do not want to get surgery at all whatsoever. I had the appendicitis surgery, which is just like three small incisions. It's called laparoscopic. And that took 2 weeks to heal. I can't imagine, like, a C-section is a major surgery where they cut like the bottom of your tummy to get the baby out. Like, I can't imagine how hard that would be to go through that surgery and then to take care of a newborn and also a toddler and then deal with breastfeeding, which is just like too much for me. So I'm doing everything I can to flip this baby. And as you can see, I do some pretty weird things. I'm slightly embarrassed to show you, but I've been doing really, really weird things. Like, okay, it's called spinning babies, and they tell you to do like a forward leaning inversion, which basically you have to put your whole body down to flip the baby. I got kind of lightheaded doing this. Pretty ridiculous. And then I also had to lie on Aris's slide because it's at an incline, and that one is called the breech lift, where you kind of let gravity take the baby out of the pelvis and into more of like your sac so that it could flip over. All these voodoo things, I'm trying everything. I'm even going to the acupuncturist to get needles poked into me to kind of open up my nerves and blood flow. And then there's also this thing called moxibustion where you take this stick, it's like a stick of charcoal, at the acupuncturist it was like mugwort, but basically you do like this hot and cold method down at your pinky toes to warm up your nerves or whatever the blood flow. I am starting to feel kicks up here, like near my ribs, so I am hopeful that the baby has flipped. Regardless, if you guys think it's interesting to watch all of these things that I'm doing to help flip the baby, if you know anyone that's in the same situation or has tried it and wanna see like how to flip a baby, I am happy to document this. I am trying everything and it's actually pretty ridiculous and entertaining to look back on. So heck, maybe I might just do a video for my own entertainment. My mom said, my belly is the shape of someone that's having a boy, but my face has zero glow, so I look like I am having a girl, because she says the girl sucks the life out of you, and so she doesn't know what I'm having. Neither do I. So I am at the La Colombe and Tillamook event to sponsor Alzheimer's diseases. And it's just like a cute little barbecue block party. I'm so excited to have some ice cream. It was so much fun. We had food from Chef Hollingsworth. He was like a winner from, I think it's called Final Table on Netflix. And they did like this whole barbecue spread, cornbread with this smoky honey butter. So good. And then heirloom tomatoes with watermelon and mint salad, which I feel like that was my favorite dish of all. I'm totally gonna recreate that. And then some smoked brisket, which was really yummy too. But I got to taste all of the featured flavors from Tillamook, and I swear, like, I think they make their ice cream from full fat or something because it's so creamy and delicious. But since I got to have ice cream, Nate and Arisi wanted to have ice cream too because they didn't attend the event. So we all went to Wanderlust Creamery afterwards in Atwater Village, and we got ube and smoky road, or like rocky road. Yeah. Oh my god.
It's dressing, playing in the daytime. Goosebumps rise at night.
Summer has been good. We got together with our friends and we celebrated baby number two. These guys crack me up with their baby food tasting. Oh, that was so much fun.
Ah, what is that?
What flavor is that?
It's like asparagus or something.
Okay, put asparagus. Wow, honey, what? They don't make asparagus, baby food. You ate that like a baby too. Like it got all over your lips.
Hi, buddy. Oh my god, I have no idea, but are we gonna cook for the babies? I'm sorry.
Yes!
Oh, I really don't know.
Babe, Josh, stop! I'm gonna put baby poop in your mouth.
I'm gonna do something else.
Like, watch me.
I really wanted to do a poopy diaper, like, tasting where you smear the candy on the diaper to make it look like poop and they have to, like, taste it or like sniff it to figure out which candy it was, but that was too complicated and it was really hot that day, so it would have been a mess. But it was the most beautiful baby shower ever, and Nate and I are just so thankful for our SoCal family for putting it together. It's been such a whirlwind. Started off with 4th of July, and then we traveled, did a ton of work for the shoot, and then came back here, had doctor's appointments, and finally I am ready to nest. Next month, I'm hoping that I get to kind of get the baby stuff ready. Since we don't know the gender, I don't really have a ton to plan. We have all the basic furniture, clothing stuff. I got a few like very neutral things from the baby shower. I think we're just ready. Actually, I'm not really ready for the baby's arrival. I love feeling the kicks and I love just being pregnant in general. So I feel like I'm gonna miss this a lot. But there might always be baby number three. You never know. Nate says no, but I am open to the idea. We'll see. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. If you want to see more, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, give this video a like, and I will see you on the next video, which will be a cooking one. Bye!
Blessing baby in the daytime. Goosebumps rise at night. And settle back down at sunrise.